In this illustration, we'll analyze a sphere rolling on a wedge. We are given that a uniform solid sphere of mass m and radius r, rolling without a slipping down on an inclined wedge of same mass as shown. Here we are required to find the velocity of wedge when sphere reaches the bottom of this wedge. Now, in this situation, we can analyze the case when the sphere reaches the bottom of wedge, then wedge will attain a leftward velocity because in this situation, no external force is acting on the system in horizontal direction. So, its system center of mass must be at rest. Here, the wedge is of mass m and the sphere is also of mass m. Here we can consider if the sphere attains a velocity v1 with respect to the wedge and wedge is moving toward left with a velocity v2 with respect to ground, then here we can write as no external force in horizontal direction is acting on system here. We use the conservation of momentum in horizontal direction. We use by conservation of momentum as here we can write toward left the wedge has attained a momentum mv2 and toward right the ball has attained a momentum m. This v1 cos theta minus v2, because here we have taken the v1 as a velocity of ball with respect to wedge. So in this situation, with respect to horizontal, v1 is moving at an angle theta. So ball is moving toward right at v1 cos theta, as well as it is moving with the wedge toward left with v2. So simplifying this relation here, m gets cancelled out and this will give us v1 is equals to 2v2 by cos theta. And we can write by work energy theorem, the kinetic energy gained in wedge as well as in that of ball is due to the work done by gravity. So here work done by gravity is mgh. And that should be the gain in kinetic energy of wedge plus ball. So for wedge it is half mv2 square plus for ball we can write it is half m. It has two velocity components. So we can write one as the horizontal velocity component, which is v1 cos theta minus v2 whole square plus v1 sine theta whole square, plus the rotational energy attained by the ball as it is rotating at angular speed omega, which is with respect to a wedge, its velocity is v1 divided by its radius. So we can write its rotational energy as half I omega square, which is 2 by 5 mr square multiplied by v1 by r whole square. Now, if we simplify this relation, here this gives us m gets cancelled out in the whole equation. This gives us 2gh is equals to v2 square plus v1 square plus v2 square minus 2v1 v2 cos theta plus 2 by 5 v1 square. And now for V1, we can substitute the value in terms of V2 from this equation. This gives us 2GH is equals to, here this will be 2V2 square plus V1 square plus 2 by 5 V1 square. We can write as 7 by 5 V1 square. So this 7 by 5 and v1 square we can write as 4v2 square divided by cos square theta, and minus here we can write V1 cos theta is equals to 2V2, so this becomes 4V2 square. Further on simplifying this relation, we get the value of V2 is equals to under the root of 5GH divided by 14 sec square theta minus 5, that is the result of this problem.